Okay, this is going to be my first attempt at an oil and filter change on my WR450F, which is a 2011 bike, the last of the carburetor models. So the instructions say we've got to start it first. So I'm going to unlock it all, take it off the stand, start it, etc. Okay, the engine's been run for 2-3 minutes, and now I've got to remove the engine guard, these bolts. Right, so it seems to be just three areas to bolt off here. One, two, and right the way under there, there's one last one. You can just about see it there. Hopefully that's in the right place for the camera. So just remove those. Obviously I'd loosened the bolts with the spanner beforehand. But look at that. I clearly haven't been cleaning that out too well. So having removed the mess and inspected that, you can see I've got a few nasty cracks there and a chunk out there. And so next on the list of purchases will be a guard for that. Right, I'm then supposed to place this that I just bought under there so it catches it all, and of course make sure you take the drain plug out. It's a bit stiff. So drain plug removed. I'm going to have a look underneath here to find the drain socket that we need to move, or remove, I should say. Alright, so as you can see, that there, I've already loosened it, is the 12mm oil drainage bolt that you just pull out or unscrew and then pulls out with the washer on, and out comes the oil. Now I'm going to do a filter change as well, so the filter is on the other side, so we have to go around the other side of the bike. I'll do that in a moment, but just so you can see, that's pretty yucky oil. I've done probably just over 500 miles since the previous oil change, which was done by garage at the service. One thing to remember, which I obviously forgot to do, is to remove this first, because that allows the air to go through, and then out comes the oil. There it goes. Missed that slightly. There you go, the mess I made, because I didn't have that lined up. And the difference of the speed of the oil coming out when you pull out the top dipstick point. There we go. Not the best of oil changes there, but out comes the oil, nice and quick. Okay, around this side, it seems to be this bolt here. You can see I've undone it with an Allen key, but can't see much coming out of that. That's supposed to be the drain for, as far as I can tell, the oil filter. Okay, the next one it says is to undo one hidden behind here. You're just about to see it up behind there. It's this one here. She's in there, you can see between the gap. You need a spanner, couldn't get a socket set on there. I've loosened it. It was a bit tough to undo. As you can see, it's on this side. Gives you an idea where it is. So we come with that one. And out comes a lot of oil. There you go. Here we go. So you can see why you need to do both sides, otherwise you're not going to get all the oil out. And those washers look good to me. Doesn't look like I need to replace them. They were replaced at the last service by the looks of it, so I can trust my mechanic. There you go. So one thing to remember when draining the oil is to remove the oil cap there and the dipstick cap there as well. Remove those two, oil comes gushing out. Leave those in, it's going to come out very, very slowly. So make sure you remember to do that. It doesn't tell you to do this in the manual, but I'm going to just level it a bit, see if any oil, more oil comes out. See a little bit more dripping out maybe, not much, because you've got the drainage on both sides anyway. As you can see on this stand, the bolts are different. The one on the right is much fatter. That's from the right side of the crankcase, and that's from the left side of the crankcase. So it does make a bit of a difference there. Oops. Now going to go back and remove the other three bolts, or the other two I should say, from the oil filter. So okay, so we're almost there, and that's those bolts out on the top right. It's the long one, short one, top or bottom left, and the medium one is the bottom one. There we go. You can see those there, so we know top right, that's the bottom one we took out first, left is the short one. And we remove that, out comes a gunked up filter. We can look at all the rings in there. They look fine to me, but I'm not an expert. But I don't have any spare ones, so there we go. They're gonna have to make do, and hopefully we won't have a leak. All right, I've not been very organised. As you can see, I've got the filter there. That's gonna go in there. I did have a spare bolt here. Not even sure which one it fits. It's a magnetic one. I had some washers just in case I needed those, but they're not even the right ones. But there we go. Hopefully we're going to be good. And looking around there, seems didn't even have a gasket of any sort there. But we literally just, that comes off, it's a bit pushed on. Grab a new one. Grab that new one, it can only go on one way. That's where I've wiped up the oil leak a bit. So we just literally push that in. Seems to just fit in like that. Clearly would be easier if I had someone holding the camera for me, but that just goes back in there like that. Grab the bolts. Let's take those two again. Do the long one first. Okay, having replaced and tightened the oil filter, and replaced the oil filter drain bolt, that's they tell you to put that one in. Then the next say, put the right hand crankcase drain bolt in as well. So in that one goes. Let me get the angle right, there we go. And it goes. Sniffling.
What did you say?
Well, the last one it says to put in, it's the one on this side. wipe the other side so that hopefully when I put the oil in, I'll be able to tell if there's any leaks or not. Hopefully there won't be. But this is the last one to go in. Right, well, this hasn't quite gone to plan and got a major problem, because when I do up that last sump screw, look at that, just keeps going. The thread's completely gone. Just keeps going again. I'm going to twist it round because it doesn't even catch. See, catches there and then loose again. Just keeps going, and then I can just hand bring it out. So I'm stuffed. Gonna have to try and figure out how to re-thread that in there, which is not gonna be fun. Okay, so following from yesterday's havoc where we lost the thread, you will see there's a brand new bolt there, just in here, with new washers, and what you can see there's the new internal threading system that the mechanic did urgently for me today so that I can get out on the road tomorrow. So this is where we're at. They should be tightened, he said, to the correct level when you check the other side. And so although I was doing the oil change myself and that's what we're doing, I'm now going to put 1.2 litres of oil in. So let's start with the next stage. Okay, I'm using Castrol Power One Racing 10W40 four-stroke motor oil, and look at that, I've done a jug which is on the 1 litre mark. It says 1.2 litres in the manual, so here goes 1 litre, and then we'll do 200 mil off. As you can see, the oil goes down fairly slowly, but being careful to make sure it all goes in, and pouring in from the jug bit by bit. Actually, looking back at the manual, it's not particularly clear. It says oil quantity 0.95 litres for an oil change with oil filter replacement 1 litre. So in fact, I've put 1 litre in now. So I don't really get where it says total amount 1.2 litres. Not sure where the 0.2 comes from. So I'm going to do the 1 litre that I put in now, and then I'll do the engine start, let it run, and then do the dipstick check. But first of all, clearly got to put these back in, including the dipstick, but we'll start with that one. Dipstick. outside to do that, so I don't gas myself in the garage, which would not be a good idea. We're now going to put the dipstick in, keeping the bike level, so we know it's at the right level. Stick the dipstick in. Try and do that whilst holding the camera's a bit tricky. Let's do that now. In goes the dipstick, and what do we have? It's, I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but it's on the X's exactly where it should be, which is precisely what we want. Okay, as you probably saw when the engine was running, but probably couldn't hear, I was doing quick checks to make sure nothing was leaking. I've done that all around on all the bolts, and there isn't anything leaking. I've double checked it, getting a clean bit of cloth, and just make sure on both sides, and we're good to go. All that's left is to put this back on, which I'm obviously don't need to show you, saw me take it off, and then we're good to go. Excellent, that's my first oil change. Rather more complicated due to that bolt stripping, but there we go. Shouldn't take me as long next time, I hope.